Dear students, this is our 14th lecture in the series of named reactions. And in today's lecture, we will discuss what is Hayama reaction or Hayama coupling. Basically, the Hayama reaction or Hayama coupling is the combination of organic halides with organosilicon compounds in presence of palladium catalyst and a base, and most commonly used base is fluoride ions for the generation of new carbon-carbon. So when the organosilanes they react with the organic halides, the product formation through new carbon-carbon bond has been found to be very chemoselective and regioselective it is. And this coupling can be applied for the formation of a new carbon-carbon bond where the one coupling partner will be organic halide, which may be alkyl halide, aryl halide, alkynyl halides, or alkynyl halides. So organic halides having carbon-carbon triple bond, organic halides having carbon-carbon double bond, organic halides having aryl group attached to them, or alkyl group attached to them. So all these types of organic halides, they can be used. And in addition, this X may be triplet also. So we can say pseudo halides, they can also be used for these types of coupling reactions. So when these types of organic halides or pseudo halides, they react with organosilanes, where these R groups, they may be aryl, alkynyl, or alkynyls, or this R2 group, this may be chloride, fluoride, or alkyl group. So depending upon the type of substitution, we can use different types of organosilanes. So when these two they react, a new carbon-carbon bond is formed in a chemoselective and regioselective manner to give us different types of products. Now, as far as these organosilanes is concerned, they are less reactive in comparison to other reagents which are used in organometallic reactions. For example, Grignard reagent or organocopper reagents, they are much more reactive in comparison to organosilicon compounds. But the chemoselectivity of these reactions is lower as compared to the chemoselectivity of the organosilicon compounds. In addition, the other organometallic reagents based on zinc metal or tin metal or boron metal, there also there are some issues which are there. For example, in case of organozinc reagents, the moisture sensitivity of these reagents is a problem. Similarly, in case of organotin compounds, they are found to be more toxic in comparison to other organometallic reagents. Then organoboron reagents, their availability is an issue, and further they are also very expensive in nature, and their stability is also an issue. So to overcome these drawbacks of organomagnesium or organo copper or organozinc or organotin or organoboron reagents, we can use organosilicon reagents or organosilanes. They can be used. The only difference of activity is that organosilanes, they are inactive in nature. So for their activation, we need to use a base or fluoride ions for making them active for this these types of Hayama coupling reactions. for the formation of a carbon-carbon bond in a chemoselective and regioselective manner. As far as mechanism of Hayama coupling is concerned, the catalytic cycle is followed in such a way that it starts with palladium catalyst in its zero oxidation state, and in zero oxidation state it reacts with the organic halide or pseudo halide and undergoes oxidative addition across the palladium to give us these types of palladium 2 intermediates. And these palladium 2 intermediates, they undergo transmetallation reaction with organosilanes, and transfer of this CH2 Arbor group takes place from the organosilane to the palladium complex, and we will get these types of palladium complexes by transmetallation reaction. And then these types of palladium 2 intermediates, they undergo reductive elimination to generate the products with new carbon-carbon bond formation, and palladium catalyst is generated back to complete the catalytic cycle. There are many modifications of Hayama coupling which have been used for the effective synthesis of chemoselective and regioselective products. For example, most common among these modification is use of xyla cyclobutane ring. When this xyla cyclobutane ring reacts with a fluoride source like tetrabutyl ammonium fluoride, then this is converted into an organosilanol, and this organosilanol can undergo dimerization, which is in equilibrium with this monomer, with elimination of water molecule, when two molecules of this organosilanol they react to give us these types of silyl ethers as the intermediate. And these intermediates, they react again with the fluoride source, tetrabutyl ammonium fluoride, and we get these types of pentacoordinated silicone compounds, which are very much activated to undergo Hayama coupling reactions. The reason for this activation of these types of pentacoordinated silicone compounds is that here the release of the strain due to the Lewis acidity takes place. So when these xyla cyclobutanes ring, they react with the fluorine source, then from a tetrahedral it is converted into a trigonal bipyramidal structure. And because of the strain release, this type of intermediate becomes activated and undergo Hayama coupling reactions. Then the activation, as I have told you, through fluoride source takes place, and there are some conditions which have been developed in recent years where we can use fluoride-free Hayama couplings also. So instead of fluoride, the use of sodium hydroxide as an activator has also been reported when these types of organochlorosilanes, they react with aryl halides, then in presence of palladium acetate and sodium hydroxide, they undergo Hayama coupling at this carbon and at this carbon with the elimination of these groups to give us Hayama cross-coupling products. So basic advantage of this is that here we do not use need to use a fluoride source. Instead, we can use very mild sodium hydroxide alkali as an activator. Then another type of important modification is Hayama-Danmar coupling. And here also use of fluoride is avoided. So for these types of coupling reactions, we don't use fluoride as an activator. Instead, we use organosilanol salts and organic halides as the coupling partners. So when organosilanols they react with organic halide in presence of palladium catalyst and a base, base is also based on silane, and then we will get products with new carbon-carbon bond formation. And mechanism of this reaction, which is a modification of Heerma coupling and known as Heerma-Denmark coupling, is almost same as Heerma coupling, except that here we use aryl halides. For example, aryl bromide is used when in the first step it reacts with the palladium catalyst. Through oxidative addition we will get these types of palladium 2 intermediates. Then these palladium 2 intermediates, they will undergo transmetallation reaction with these types of potassium saline alkoxides. So these through transmetallation transfer, this saline oxide part of the molecule to the palladium intermediate to give us these types of intermediates which contain palladium as well as organosilane part. Then this intermediate undergoes elimination of dimethyl saline oxide from here, and this R is transferred to the palladium to give us these types of palladium intermediates. And these palladium intermediates, they undergo reductive elimination for the formation of a product where a new carbon-carbon bond is formed between the R group and the aryl group. Aryl group from aryl halide, and R group is transferred from the organosilane. So this is how we get products through Heerma-Denmark coupling reactions. Then as far as applications of these Heerma reactions they are concerned, the most important application in case of Heerma coupling is its use in the polymerization reactions. So we can undertake polycondensation reactions in case of bifunctional alkenyl silanes, either E configuration or Z configuration of these types of substrates. So when E alkenyl silanes or Z alkenyl silanes, they are reacted with aryl iodides in presence of these types of allyl palladium chloride complexes in presence of a fluoride source, then we can get E polyaryline vinylenes or Z polyaryline vinylenes. Now, whether only E product will be formed or Z product will be formed or a mixture of both of these they will be formed is very much dependent on the type of substrate which we use during these polycondensation reactions. So, for example, when we use E alkenyl silanes as the substrate under these conditions, we get E polyaryline vinylenes as products in 99% yield with retention of configuration. So E to Z ratio in these cases is that E product is formed in more than 99% amount, whereas this Z is formed less than 1%, and product is formed with retention of configuration, we can say. And the molecular weight of the product formed after polycondensation is in the range of 500 to 6300 mL. And it has also been found that if instead of this we use this catalyst, tetra triphenyl phosphine palladium is used, then no polymerization takes place. So the polymerization takes place only with this allyl palladium chloride catalyst. Similarly, if we undertake a polycondensation reaction with Z-alkynylsilane under similar conditions, then also we will get polyarylene, vinylene as the products. But here, the molecular weight of the product formed is less than what we have got with the E-alkynylsilanes. And also here, in case of Z-alkynylsilanes, we will get both the products, E as well as Z polycondensation products. They are formed, and Z to E ratio in this case ranges from 45 to 55 or 34 to 66. So Z enantiomer or Z isomer is formed in the range of 45 to 55, whereas E ranges from 34 to 66. So that means both the products, they are formed in this case. So some product is formed, we can say, with retention of conformation, whereas other product is formed with inversion of. So that means whether the product formed will be with the retention of configuration or inversion of configuration, it depends on the type of substrate which we are using for these types of polycondensation reactions. Then some more examples, when these types of heterocyclic organosilanes, they are reacted with aryl iodides, then a new carbon-carbon bond is formed between this carbon and this carbon. So trimethylsilyl iodide is removed and a new carbon-carbon bond is formed between these two under Yama conditions. So we will get 4-chloro-2-4-methoxypyridine as the product in these cases in 82% yield. Similarly, if we use these types of organosilanes having carbonyl group present in them, they react with aryl halides to give us ketones as the product. So when these types of aryl bromides, they are reacted with these types of trimethylsilyl having acetyl group, so they give us these types of acetophenones as the product. Then the aryl organosilanes or arylsilanes, they react with 3-hydroazetidines to give us 3-aryl-azetidines as the product, and a carbon-carbon bond is formed between this carbon and this carbon with the removal of silane part from here and iodide part from here under Hayama conditions. Then in recent years, reusable silicon-based transfer agents, they have also been found effective for palladium-catalyzed cross-coupling reactions under Yama conditions. So when these silyl transfer agents, they react with aryl lithium compounds and aryl halides, then biphenyls, they are formed as the product with the formation of a new carbon-carbon bond. So this carbon and this carbon of the carbon-lithium bond, they form a new carbon-carbon bond, and lithium chloride is removed in presence of silyl transfer reagent and a palladium precatalyst of this type. Then midavinylsilanes, N-methyl amino diacetate. So this is N-methyl amino diacetate. Vinylsilanes, they react with aryl halides, which are converted in presence of palladium catalyst into these types of organovinylsilane compounds. And these organovinylsilanes, they react with aryl iodides to give us functionalized stilbenes as the product. in presence of a chlorine source as the base. Then few more common example, we can extend this Hammer coupling in heterocyclic compounds also. So when thiophene derivatives, thiophene iodides and organosilicon compounds based on thiophene, they are reacted under Hammer conditions using KF as the fluorine source. Then a new carbon-carbon bond is formed between this thiophene at this place, this carbon and this carbon, with the elimination of this part from this molecule and iodide from this molecule to give us these types of bithiophene products. The product is formed in 82%. Then these types of aryl silanes, they react with the heteroaryl halides. So similarly, a carbon-carbon bond is formed between this heterocyclic component and this aryl component with the removal of trimethoxysilane from here and bromide from here. And we will get these types of products with the formation of a new carbon. Then Hammer coupling can also take place in an intramolecular fashion if both organic halide and organosilane part is present within the same one. So these types of silyl ethers and vinyl iodides, they react with each other under Hammer coupling conditions in presence of a fluoride source. They undergo cyclization at this point and this point to give us these types of cyclic compounds as the product. So in this way we can synthesize a higher member cyclic structure through intramolecular Hammer coupling reaction, and product is formed in 61%. These are the references which have been consulted for preparing this lecture. Thank you very much.